Hello guys, welcome back again to Netcode-Hub channel. In this video, we are going to talk about how to create pie chart, donut chart, pyramid chart, and funnel chart. Aside from that, when I hover the mouse on, you can see large bars I have 45, mini bars I have 24, carry I have 60, saloon I have 5, and oven I have 12. Now we see the various presentations have been aligned over here, as you can see. And that is why, as soon as I click on that, that place get highlighted. So you see, I am just okay. So I'm disabling it, and I can enable it as well. So how do you able to do it? And that is what we're going to take a look at in this video. Okay. So we're going to cover this this pie chart, donut chart, pyramid chart, and funnel chart in this video. And we're going to use a Syncfusion component to able to create or draw these graphs. So if I zoom one, if I zoom in, so you can see we have the chart over here. You can see we have the list here. They did not have the list, and there's the title, car and passenger statistics, and that's over here. So if I go down there, there's the pyramid. You could have exactly the same thing as well. Saloon, and have it in the funnel too, I have exactly the same. In my previous video, I talked about how to create bullet chart. So we talk about bullet chart, we talk about how to generate a QR code and barcode, we talk about that too as well. How to create navigation bar, that's a navbar, talk about that too as well. So you can check in this playlist and I have a full list of important videos for you to watch, which is going to help you to design your dashboard and look nice. So how do you implement this in your dashboard to just represent the data in a graph form? That is what we have to take a look at. So without wasting much time, let's get right into it and let's see. So let's first create a project. So create Blazor WebAssembly project. So after creating the project, this is what you have to do first. You have to install some Syncfusion packages, because that is what we are going to use to create that chart, as you see. So in order to install that, go to Solution Explorer. Now if you are not seeing Solution Explorer, click on View. And Solution Explorer is going to be there. You click on Solution Explorer here. Now right click on dependencies and now click on manage NuGet packages. So with the NuGet packages, try to click on that, and now you are going to add the following packages. So we need to add a theme, and we need to add the chart. So since I'm running mine, you can see I can't click on that, but if you click yours, make sure you download this. So type in to download this component and dependencies, packages, download this one, blazor.theme. So that is syncfusion.blazor.themes. Download that. Aside from that, download syncfusion.blazor.chat. So we need these two components for our chat, our graph, to be able to work. Okay, so now once you have that downloaded, if you are not, pause the video and try to download them to that side, and let's move on with that. So the next thing that we're going to talk about here is after creating the table, after also creating the project and installing these packages, what you have to do here is you have to go to the import.razor and import those files in there. So you can see we have using syncfusion.blazor.chat, we have it over here as well, so that you can actually use it any part or any page of ours. All right, so once you are done with this, let's go to program.ts file. We need to register and call for the services. Here you have to use the namespace using syncfusion.blazor and using builder.services.addsyncfusionblazor. That is the licensing, but for now, if you're not having a license, no problem, it's still going to work as well, so don't worry about that. So once you have these two things set up, we can now go in and implement the chart. So we need to create a page, to add a page to the pages folder, and I'm naming my pie pyramid and funnel chart, because you're having almost three charts at once. So having pie, pyramid, and funnel, so three charts. So let me check here and see. All right, so you have pie. The pie can have the donut over here, and I can talk about pyramid and funnel, so three. But with the pie chart, because I have a donut part as well, but they are all one together. All right, so once I have the next thing to do here is, let's go to a page that has been created, a new created page. Now here is a bootstrap design, so I'm not going to talk much about bootstrap, you know, because this is not a bootstrap video. If you want to learn bootstrap, how to design the pages into four layers, as I've done here, then I think you have to watch my bootstrap videos. Okay, so go to the playlist and find for a bootstrap tutorials, and you're gonna have to do this. But for now, you're using the colon MD6 because the OPG is 12, so we are using 6 6 making 12 and 6 6 making 12 as well. All right, so in here we have the studio, and that is the component. So SF, that stands for Syncfusion Accumulation Chart, and that is the title. So the title is what is being displayed over here. So car and passenger statistics. So that is it. Now, aside from that, we see we have accumulation chart series collection. So with this collection, we're going to have a single collection in it. And as you can see from here, we have accumulation chart series. So aside from the collections, that's the opening tag and that's the closing tag. Okay. Now, in between that, we have accumulation chart series. That is whereby we specify the type of chart is it. So type is equal to accumulation type dot pi. So this, it means we need a pi. We're going to use a pi. Now the data source here is chart data. Keep this chart data, talk about it, okay? Now the X name is car, the Y name is passenger. The X name here is what? Well, that's the X axis, and the Y name is what? Y axis. Now with the X axis, we are replacing car with it, and the Y axis, we are replacing passengers. That is very simple. So keep them, the kind of passengers, we understand this very soon. Now we are having labels set to be visible. So that's what you see, we have the numbers in between. So 24 minibus, 24. We have this large bags and carrier. So these are the labels, and we have set them to visible. That's what you can actually see over here. And now also for tooltip 2, we have also enabled that. And so that's what you can see from here. Accumulation chart tooltip settings, we set it to true. That's for enable. And exactly, you see right here, we see you have a label that tells us where you are. That is perfect. All right, so once you're done with this, the next thing to do here is the donut. So the same thing applies to here, is also the same thing as pi. But instead of this, we're going to set the inner radius to 40%. So set inner radius to 40%, the same data, and we are going to have the donut, this donut symbol or this donut graph. Now let's go to the pyramid and the chart. It's actually the same thing as we've done. So just change from here, instead of the pi, we change to what? Pyramid, and we change this to what? Funnel. We are done. That is very simple, and thanks to Syncfusion, their component is very interesting and they are easy to implement as well. Now we talked about some data, that is the data source, chart data, and the X and the Y axis. Where do these originate from? Let's go to the code and see what we have now. Now when it comes to the code, you can see that we are having a class stated here, and the class here, you can see the name of the class is chart data model. So there's a model. And this model contains two properties, that is the car and passenger. So we are talking about here how the car type and the number of passengers it can pick. Okay, so when you have this set, you have to populate this and get the data. So we populate it with a list, and now we say that the first car is saloon car, and you know this saloon car, this small small cars, and passengers it pick normally what, 5, 3 at the back and driver, and the other one beside, making 5. Now aside from that, you can see we have from oven. Now oven picks maybe 12 or 8, and we can see we have mini bars, that is a 24 at times 20 at times 24. We have the large bars, and it picks what, 45, and the carriers pick what, that is a passengers of what, 60. So this is the data, that this is the dummy data actually. I haven't gone out to check, ask them how many passengers does your car pick. I haven't done that, okay, but this is just a dummy data that we're using to create our graph. So we're doing this, we have the data here, and we're using this passengers for the Y coordinate, and we're using this car for the X coordinate. So that is why we pass in X axis as what, cars, and Y axis as passengers. That is very simple. So this simple data, we have it. So with this, when you have, if you want to grab it from the database, it's very simple. You see we have your models already. So here you have to just populate it, and now you have to assign the variables to the X and the Y coordinate, and you are done. So when you run this, you're going to have this beautiful design, or this beautiful chart, as you can see from here. You know, from this project, I'm going to leave it at the GitHub, and I'll definitely add a link to a page where you can actually download it, and also the source code as well. So if you're interested in it, you can just go to the description and grab the source code over there. And I also have a sample videos over there for barcode, for bullet charts and other ones as well, navigation bars and etc. You can just watch them to improve your performance in your application or web design. Okay, so these are very nice in terms of integrating them into your dashboard, okay, to give us the full view, the full stack of a product or of any object that you want to portray on the dashboard. Alright, so that is it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I believe this is clear and you're able to get it. In case you have any issue, to let me know, and hopefully I'm going to catch you up in the next video.